Recently, there have been a number of videos discussing the current state of film music. More specifically, these videos have examined why the music for the Marvel Cinematic Universe is unmemorable. Every Frame of Painting, which is an outstanding channel with a host of terrific insights on film, made a video about how imitation, temp tracking, and a play-it-safe attitude has rendered the MCU music uniform and forgettable. And then, a video entitled A Theory of Film Music was released in response to Every Frame of Painting's video. This video delved into some of the more technical reasons why Hollywood blockbusters all have a similar musical sound. And while both of these videos make terrific points, they fail to mention what is, in my opinion, the biggest reason why the music for the Marvel Cinematic Universe is unmemorable, and that reason is a lack of thematic continuity. To illustrate this point, we have to start at the beginning. In 2008, Ramin Djawadi wrote the first musical score for an MCU film, and in doing so, he wrote a pretty appropriate theme for the Tony Stark Iron Man character. But 2 years later, when Iron Man 2 was released, Marvel and director Jon Favreau hired a new composer, John Debney, and Djawadi's original theme was nowhere in sight. In 2013, director Shane Black stepped in to finish the Iron Man trilogy, and he brought with him a new composer, Brian Tyler. What he did not bring along was either of the past two themes. It's not that any one of these themes is bad, or that they fail to capture the sound of Iron Man, but it's really hard for a theme to grow synonymous with the character when it's discarded after one movie. What if Djawadi's theme had stuck with the character in the following movies? Or what if Tyler was scoring this trilogy from the start? But Iron Man isn't the only culprit. In 2011, Patrick Doyle provided Thor with a rousing theme. But, in 2013, a new director and new composer took over the Thor franchise. And the theme was, you guessed it, totally changed. The first Captain America movie featured an outstanding theme by one of the most revered composers alive, Alan Silvestri. And while hints and snippets of the theme remained in Captain America: The Winter Soldier, the main theme was, once again, rewritten by Henry Jackman. These examples stand to show just how little thematic continuity there is in the music from Marvel's movies. And while the studio has done an exemplary job of carefully interconnecting their films, they have paid much less attention to interconnecting the music in their movies. But let's look at when Marvel does thematic continuity right. The theme for the first Avengers movie, written again by Alan Silvestri, is probably the most memorable theme in the MCU. Is this theme memorable because it is significantly better than any of the other Marvel themes? Or is the theme memorable because it actually was preserved in the sequel, Avengers: Age of Ultron? Here, Danny Elfman uses Silvestri's theme along with his original material to form a developed version of the Avengers theme. And when we need it most, the original theme returns in all of its glory. If Marvel had retrospectively taken a page out of Age of Ultron's book, by keeping its themes from film to film and developing them over the course of their respective franchises, then whenever the next Avengers installment rolled around, there could have been an incredibly rich thematic landscape defining the MCU. Imagine all these singular character themes maturing and playing together in the same sandbox. We wouldn't be talking about how unmemorable the MCU music is. We would be talking about, perhaps, the most exciting fixture in current blockbuster film scoring. So, why is the music for the MCU forgettable? Is it because of temp tracking? Or the modern Hans Zimmer film scoring approach? Sure. But more so than anything else, unmemorable musical identity in the MCU has little to do with the quality of the themes themselves, and everything to do with having a different Iron Man theme each time he appears in a new movie.